Welcome to our Piping Engineering YouTube channel. We continue our free piping education videos in this channel. Before starting this video, please subscribe to our education YouTube channel to watch more piping engineering videos. You can also benefit from some benefits by membership to our channel. In this video, we will show step by step how to calculate the distance between the centers of the elbows in the pipeline, the cut elbows length and the length of the pipe piece between these elbows in the isometric drawing and 3D model view of pipeline. Let's starting pipe tutorial video. We will perform the calculations in this video on a 6-inch pipeline. To find the length of the blue color pipe piece between these two elbows, first we must calculate the distance between the centers of the elbows. On next stage, we need to find the lengths of the 6-inch cut elbows, and finally from the total length between the centers of the elbows we will subtract the lengths of the cut elbows and the gaps for welding. Let's go step by step. As you can see, the 6-inch pipe is first going southwards, then inclined up to a height of 400 mm, and then continues horizontally again. At the same time, the pipeline has turned 600 mm to the eastwards horizontally, looking from the second elbow to the first elbow. For easy understanding of the pipeline turn from the second elbow, the pipeline turn is shown inside the parallelogram. So that the first elbow in the pipeline is located in the lower right corner of the parallelogram and the second elbow is located in the upper left corner of the parallelogram. Two right triangles are formed with dashed lines after the pipeline rises obliquely 400 mm and rotated 600 mm. Let's mark the vertical right angle triangle with blue color and horizontal right angle triangle with red color. The hypotenuse of the vertically blue right angle triangle is the distance between the elbows in the pipeline. Also, let's mark the hypotenuse of the blue right angle triangle with big letter H and the hypotenuse of the red right angle triangle with small letter h. Now let's begin to find the lowercase letter h, which is the hypotenuse of the horizontal red right angle triangle. As you can see, the perpendicular sides of this red right angle triangle are 800 mm and 600 mm. We will use the Pythagorean theorem formula in such cases to calculating the hypotenuse of this right angle triangle. According to the Pythagorean theorem, small letter h squared will be equals 800 squared plus 600 squared. Continued to calculate and found the small h squared is equals 1 million. We continue, small h is equals 1 million under root. At last we will use scientific calculator and found small h is equals 1000 millimeters. 1000 millimeters is the hypotenuse of the horizontal red color right angle triangle and is also one of the perpendicular sides of the vertical blue right angle triangle. Now let's find the big letter h, which is the hypotenuse of the vertical blue right angle triangle. We will use the Pythagorean theorem formula again in such cases to calculating the hypotenuse of this right angle triangle. According to the Pythagorean theorem, big letter h squared will be equals 1000 squared plus 400 squared. Continued to calculate and found the big letter h squared will be equals 1160000. We continue, big h will be equals 1160000 under root. At last we will use scientific calculator and found big H will be equals 1077 millimeters. 1077 millimeters is the hypotenuse of the vertically blue right triangle and is also the distance between the centers of the butt weld elbows. In this pipe drawing, we can also calculate the degree of rotation of the pipeline. If we mark the rotate angle with the letter B, then B angle will be equal to arctangent 600 divided by 800. Using the scientific calculator, we find that arctangent 600 divided by 800 will be equal to 36.8 degrees. So, we calculated and found that the rotation angle of the pipeline is 36.8 degrees. Now let's calculate cut elbows angles. First we complete each elbow from the back to a right angle triangle, provided that they are on the same plane. Let's paint one of them with blue color and the other with red color. As you can see, these dashed lines and the right triangles formed by these lines are equal to each other, so the intersection angle of the elbows will be the same. Let's mark these angles of the elbows and right triangles with the letter A. In a right triangle, the length of one of the perpendicular sides, the adjacent side, is 800 mm and the length of the hypotenuse is 1077 mm. Now we can start to calculate the cutting angle A degree. According to the trigonometric function A degree, will be equals arc cosines 800 divided by 1077. Using the scientific calculator, we find that arc cosines 800 divided by 1077 will be equal to 42 degrees. So, we calculated and found that the cutting angle of the elbows is 42 degrees. Now let's calculate the dimension of the elbows from the center to the end. Formula for calculating center to end distance of such cut elbows is as follows. Elbow length in millimeters is equals tangent, elbow degree divided by 2, multiplying nominal pipe size of elbow NPS, multiplying 38.1. Now we will write details of the 6-inch 42-degree elbow to this formula. 6-inch 42-degree but weld elbow center to end dimension will be equals tangent 42 divided 2 multiplying 6, multiplying 38.1. Using the scientific calculator, we find that tangent 42 divided 2 multiplying 6, multiplying 38.1 approximately will be equal to 88 millimeters. So, we calculated and found that 6-inch 42-degree but weld elbow center to end dimension is equals 88 millimeters. Also, during fit-up there should be a gap of about 3 mm between the pipe and elbow to be welded. Having this gap is for better root welding. We should take these gaps into account when calculating the length of the blue color pipe section. If we subtract the lengths of the 42-degree cut elbows and the gaps for welding from this total length, we can find the length of the blue color pipe section. So, pipe length will be equal, total length 1077 mm, minus 2 times 6-inch 42-degree but weld elbow dimension 88 mm, and minus 2 times gaps for welding 3 mm. At last we calculate and found pipe length will be equals 895 mm. So, we found that blue pipe section length will be 895 mm. By using this method, you can easily calculate pipe lengths in the any pipe lines. This education video is finishing here. Your comments about video you can write in the comments section. By becoming a member of our channel, you can support our channel and benefit from some features. If you liked the video, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. I would like to express my thanks in advance to our viewers who write comments and likes. Thank you for watching. See you on next video. Take care.